as part of what we're doing, we're also making a large mess. And I think that this picture, by the way, is the pre-loved parts shelf at ITP. We basically load it up with things, and we tell students, you know, when you're working on a new project, don't necessarily go shopping for new components. Come over here and shop. You'll get some good ideas, and you may find some good capacitors, too. Even so, that shelf, 90% of it ends up leaving the building in a dumpster and never used again. And we go through that about once a month. So we're making a lot of mess. I think that we're irresponsible if we don't acknowledge the fact that we're making a mess, and acknowledge the fact that as people who are making things, we need to start thinking about how to change the system such that we're actually closing the loop a little bit, to steal Alex's words from this morning. Thus far, we really think about products as basically going from mine to landfill. Well, you know, all of that stuff has got to get back into the system. And that's one of the things I'm trying to focus on when we think about environmental sustainability and technology development at NYU. So, a couple of years ago, I started this class called Sustainable Practices. And the whole idea was just to get students to generate thought projects to start with. It was a good group of people, and a number of interesting projects came out of it, one of which is actually available here now, the Tentacles kit. The students in that class, what they really got was the idea that it's not just about understanding what's going on with the environment, it's not just about understanding what we need to change, it's about getting it into people's head, as I was saying before, getting in the popular imagination. So a lot of the things they did tended to be very showy, if not very practical. The Tentacles, I guess, is in some ways the most practical of the lot. Lower down the scale, we've got the solar bikini, which, well, the idea was that the bikini is just enough power to charge your iPod while you're lying on the beach. He wanted to make it so that you could charge your beer cooler, but it turns out you need board shorts for that, because you need more solar power. It was nice because it actually got people thinking about solar power. Now, if you think this is impractical, wait till you see this. I'm not even sure what it is. It's a jellyfish. It's solar powered and it jiggles. And I was okay with that though, because what the student did is he said, well, actually, there's all these broken solar cells out there and everybody assumes they're trash. I don't think they are. So what he really got out of the project was a set of instructions for people who want to be able to reuse about a bunch of cell phones. Reuse a bunch of solar panels. And that's not bad. So, this idea of silliness is something that comes up in a lot of our projects, and it's kind of key for me that you do silly things sometimes because it opens the door to people. It makes them a little more comfortable. It makes them feel like the bar is not that high. It makes them feel like they can jump in and participate. We did this with physical computing when we first started out, and we found surprisingly good results. We found that people really do jump in. They start to learn faster than they thought they would. They're not afraid. Some of this is starting to happen in, I guess, what I would call sustainable awareness projects, not just at ITP, but other places as well. And one of the first places most people tend to start is with energy. This is a project that another group of students from that class did, where we put a solar cell on the roof of ITP and they built a meter so you could watch on a daily basis exactly how many things you could run off of that day's charge. And again, not enough power to really do much other than, you know, run a couple of laptops, which isn't bad. But mostly what they learned out of it was exactly what energy is all about. And we're seeing a lot of this throughout computer science and electrical engineering programs these days. If you look at the Greener Gadgets competition, for example, which is mostly student projects, something like 40% of the top 50 projects this year were all about energy. That's pretty huge. You know, there's also projects like Watson, Rafi Krikorian's project, which you'll be hearing about later in the week, which is all about figuring out how to change your lifestyle by looking at your energy consumption. There's the other Watson, which was a beautifully designed industrial design object to monitor your current in your house. And the whole idea with this one was that if it's a beautiful object, you will actually look at it more and you might use it more. I'm not sure if that's actually the case in this case, but it certainly is a beautiful object, and if it were my house, I'd look at it a lot.